Okay, Assalamualaikum and good morning. For today we're going to do experiment number 2, determination of calcium content in milk using AAS, atomic absorption spectroscopy. So this is atomic absorption that we have in the lab. Okay, unfortunately for today we have gas problem, so we cannot run the experiment. However, I'm going to show you, going to do the demo for you guys. And the demo comprised of basically today the activity comprised of a few activity. First, we're going to do the sample preparation. Then I'm going to talk about the safety of AAS before you run the experiment. And I'm going to give you a quick tour on the AAS and try to explain the process involved in the AAS, including the instrument and the light and so on. And hopefully by end of today. We can also talk about data interpretation. We are going to share with you the result of AAS, the result, and from the result, you should be able to make your own lab reports. Alright, thank you. You continue.
Yes,
okay. Okay, step number one is sample prep. So to run AAS, what you need to do first is to do the standard first. You need to prepare the standard. Standard is a standard of a known concentration. In our case today, we're going to do a calcium standard. So what we're going to do is we're going to prepare a series of different concentration of calcium, starting from 1 ppm all the way to 5 ppm. So Pela is going to show you how to prepare the standard. So as you can see here, she's adding a few chemical. In this case, we are using TCA, tri-chloric acid. So this is basically to boost the signal when running the TCA. So she's mixing everything, and you can also refer to the manual book. So the preparation is not that difficult, just adding some chemical. So she need to do this in 3 different concentration of standard. Okay, as you can see here, this is the standard prepare. So we have a blank. So like any analysis, we need to prepare a blank first. Blank is basically the solvent we use in our standard as well as in our sample. So this is the calcium at 1 ppm, calcium at 3 ppm, and calcium at 5 ppm. So this is our sample. Okay, depends. Some sample we need to do dilution, but for today we're going to do as it is sample, and also we're going to do another dilution. So I got the sample from Dutch lady, full cream milk. So for reference later, you might want to refer at the label at the back to see where is the amount of calcium. Okay, they're not stating here calcium, but you can always get the information in the internet. Ada tak? Mana? Oh, calcium ada tu, the green one. They really highlight the calcium. So looking at this, we should get around 130 milligrams. In 100 ml of milk, so that's quite high. Alright.
Okay, like any experiment, before you start experiment, you have to look at the safety issue first. Like I mentioned before, AAS, remember we are dealing with a very high temperature. So there are a few things that you have to make sure. Make sure the safety aspect, make sure the machine is working perfectly before you can run the experiment. So the number one is you have to make sure the food, is working. In any AAS setup, it will come with the food. So make sure it's running. There's nothing's blocking the food. So because in the process AAS analysis, what happened is your sample will be atomized, will turn into atom, and there will be a gas, a metal. Maybe there's a heavy metal which is very harmful to you. So everything will be sucked inside the hood. Okay. Number two, you have to make sure the tank, the collecting tank, the waste tank, also is, before you start, make sure it is empty, because we want to get rid out of any residue, maybe harmful, into the tank. And the most important thing is to make sure the gas, like I said before, we are dealing with a very high temperature gas. We're talking about a temperature more than 1000. So in this, our setup in FSTM, we're going to use acetylene gas, acetylene gas as well as a compressed air as the oxidant. So acetylene gas, compressed air. So you must make sure the pressure is enough, especially when you deal with acetylene. Acetylene can be easily ignite, so you don't want the pressure to be low. So there's a specific very small margin pressure to run AS with acetylene. It's around 10, yeah, around 10 to 15, yes, PSI. So you have to make sure it's around that pressure. So if the gas is low in pressure, so you have to talk to the lab assistant or lab officer, make sure they change into a full tank gas. We don't want low pressure. It can do backfire and we don't want that to happen. Okay. So and in any gas setup, you can see here, there's a, in our system, we have we don't have our tank here. We have a centralized tank setup. It is outside the room. It's better to have that way. So you can see a few pressure gauges here. Pressure hub gauges. So gauge number one, and this is the valve. Make sure it's always in off. And if you want to run the system, you just turn it on. And also this is the gauge to control the pressure of the gas. So nanti when you want to start the instrument, you just turn it on and make sure the pressure is on the right pressure. Okay, right. So let me show you the diagram. This is the simple diagram of AES. So basically, there are few components involved. The main one is you're going to see the nebulizer. There will be a HCL, halocathode lamp, and also the monochromatogram and detector. And you're going to see the data processor in the form of PC. So let me show you the lamp first. In AES, it's very important. Lamp is one of the most important element. So AES, you need to have specific lamp for specific mineral that you want to measure. So here, there's a 4 slot here. This is all interchange lens. So we have a calcium, you have a manganese, magnesium, and so on. So for today experiment, we're going to do a calcium. So lamp specifically, I will explain in the lecture about the lamp. And I also want to show you, maybe you can open here, the nebulizer. This is where the burning process takes place. So what you do when you run the experiment, you can see they have a few tube here and there, for the fuel, and this is the sample tube. So imagine, let's say we are running experiment. So first, what you need to do is to prepare to have a blank. You put your blank. Prepare your blank. So basically, once you on the machine and everything's turned on, so you run the blank first. So you want to calibrate your reading. So running the blank, you put your tubes all the way down and make sure the water level, the blank level is high. And when you run this experiment, you can sort of see the liquid travel in the tubes, and there will be the color changes in the flame, indicating that the burning process has happened. So once you are done with the blank, you want to wash it with distilled water. So make sure you wash every run you do AAS. Then you start with your standard. So we already prepared 3 different concentration standard, calcium standard here. You start with the lower concentration first, 1 ppm, then 3 ppm, 5 ppm. So once you're done with the standard, then you can run your sample. Sample either can run as it is, or you have to dilute. Depend on the stand. Depend on our standard. So if the concentration is too high, exceed the standard level, you have to dilute it. One beauty about AES is pretty straightforward. Of course, you have to add something, but you don't need to do extraction and those tedious preparation method. Alright. So okay. Alright, okay, let me show you the AES that we have in food science, in teaching related food science. We are going to use AES from Peking Elmer. The model is Analyst 400 or 4000. So, okay, this is the model. So, hopefully, you can see it. That's me. Alright, Analyst 400. So of course there are many model. Each model will come with a slightly different setup, and also the working the interface will be different lah. So if you have a different model of AES, you might want to go to the manual and to see how it's run. But the principle, the basic is the same. So here. So in the PC, we have a dedicated PC for this machines. What you do is to run the machine, you need to open the software first, WinLab 32. So you click on this WinLab 32. So basically you can see interface like this. So normally we already install all the method inside the computer. So let's say you want to run calcium in milk, you just choose method that's already installed lah. Open and info sample file and so on. So just browse your method from the system, and the system will pop up for you. Just in case you are doing some modification, you need to do the you need to run the setup all over again. You have to choose the right wavelength, the right lamp and so on. So just follow the protocol. Don't worry. So once you have everything ready, so once, let me see. Okay. So once the system is open, you will see this box pop up first. So the system will check to make sure every component is function well before it allowed us to run the experiment. So you have the system will check for the machine. The flame, and also auto sampler. We also have auto sampler here, but we are not going to use it. If it's okay, you can see the tick button is on. But now, like I said before, we have problem with the flame, with the pressure of the flame, so it's not on. So once you see this problem, you might want to contact technician and to try to solve the problem. So there's a few button you can check. You can check here, spectrometer buttons. So this will tell you what's types of spectrometer used in these machines. The flame button as well. So now it's not connected. So once you're ready, you just have to let the flames on, and auto sampler button. So we don't use auto sampler for today's experiment because we're going to do manual. Alright. Okay, after running the experiment, this is how the result will turn out lah. So you can see we do the blank calibration, and you can see the electromagnetic signal. Then we do the calibration standard. We do the standard number concentration number 1, and you can see some signal, electromagnetic signal, calibration number 2 and calibration number 3. Number 4, it's up to you how many standard calibration you make. So from this data, what you need to do is you need to do the calibration curve first. Remember, we talked about you learned this before, 3114, measuring many spectroscopy, using many spectroscopy, you need to do standard curve first. So you will have a minimum concentration and you have a maximum concentration. Usually in standard curve, it will follow the Beer-Lambert law, the linear regression, where you increase your concentration with increase concentration will also increase the absorbent or any signal. Okay, so then you run your unknown sample. Unknown sample will give you a signal, some signal somewhere in between the standard curve. So from there you'll be able to determine the concentration of your unknown sample. Right.